Which is the better online assessment tool, Kahoot or Quizizz? Let's find out. Hey everybody, welcome to Mr. Cook's Corner, education for educators. This channel is all about helping teachers grow in their craft. If this is your first time watching, welcome aboard. Please consider subscribing and liking our videos if you enjoy what you see today. In previous videos, we've talked about how the gamification of learning is very important for students in order to maintain engagement as well as assess for true knowledge and understanding. This is no different when we're talking about online assessment tools. I'm taking two of them today, Kahoot and Quizizz, the two most popular apps out there, and I'm going to put them heads up in our next app smash battle. Who's going to come out ahead? Let's take a look right now. Okay, we've got seven different categories we're going to take a look at to figure out which is the best online gaming platform. The first one we want to look at is the sign up, the setup, and what add-ons do they have to each platform. Both Kahoot and Quizizz are super easy to sign up for. You can either link your Google account or you can use your work email address. Either way, they get you in the door with little to no hassle whatsoever. Kahoot does have some apps available to purchase through the Play Store, both for Apple and iOS. They range anywhere from $5 to $9. They come in more handy for homeschooling and for people who are looking for additional lessons. For us teachers, I really wouldn't recommend spending this additional money, but it is an option that Quizizz doesn't offer, but Kahoot does. However, the biggest differentiating point for this entire section is the premium add-ons. With Kahoot, if you want to have some premium options, you need to pay a monthly fee, anywhere from $3 to $9. And with that, here are some of the things that you get with it. You can access an image library. You can add extra slides in between questions to reveal more information. You can throw in polls. You can have open-ended question types. You can edit games that are already ready to play. You can view and share reports, and you can organize in folders. Now those sound like some pretty neat features, and they are, but the thing is with Quizizz, you get all that for free. There is no premium account with Quizizz. You get everything that you could possibly want under a free account. Now with Kahoot, currently with the COVID situation, they are offering free premium accounts, but that's going to go away as soon as your school opens up. You can go to their website and check for the fine print. You could get it for a few months about, but once September and October rolls around, if your school opens up, you're going to have to start paying for that premium account. In this case, Quizizz wins it hands down. The next category is just your homepage, your dashboard, and for this one, it's a straight up tie. They're both easy to navigate. They have access to your reports, to your quizzes. You can create on the fly. You can access other people's content. It's really easy to get around. In this case, I don't see anything differentiating the two. Let's take a look at content, and the library of both platforms are amazing. They have thousands upon thousands of accessible quizzes created by teachers, created by students. You can get into those with ease for free. You don't have to pay anything for it, and their search library is pretty in-depth. Both of them also have filters. So if I type in something like geometry, I can whittle them both down by grade level. I can do it by teacher-led, by student-led. It's really easy for me to narrow down what I'm looking for. One bonus that I do want to give to Quizizz is the fact that when you're previewing these lessons, all you have to do is hover over it and it will show the questions on the right-hand side without you having to click anything. In Kahoot, if you want to preview something, you have to click on it. It opens it up on a separate page. You can look and review it. It's still great, but I just like that one little bit extra for Quizizz where you just hover over it without clicking anything and it shows you exactly what you're going to be getting. Even with that bonus though, I really don't see anything differentiating one platform from the other, and in this case, I think it's pretty much a tie. Up next is the assignment category. How do we get these out to our students and what options do they have? Both Kahoot and Quizizz have a live option and they also have an assignable homework section. You take the link and you send it out to them in a number of different ways and they can take those quizzes at their own pace, at their own time, and you can assign due dates. They both work just the same and in this case, I don't see much difference going on here. In regards to access to the assignments, both Kahoot and Quizizz also have a number of ways of sending it out. You can do it through the Remind app, you can do it through Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams, or you can just do the plain old fashioned, take the URL link, post it somewhere, have them click on it, and off you go. In this case, however, I will mention that Quizizz has a very integrated Google Classroom. Now, Kahoot does as well. You can assign things through Google Classroom. There's a button that you can click on. But with Quizizz, if you do use Google Classroom a lot, you can actually link each class that you have to the account. And when you push it out, it gets to them that much quicker. And it also ties back into you, so you can send the scores that they get through Google Classroom. It's that combination of having a practice link available combined with the connectivity of Google Classroom that gives Quizizz the edge in this category. Next up is reports and grading, and this is where you as the teacher get to go in and see how your students did, what kind of access do you have to the students' performances, and in both cases, it's pretty robust. You can go in and see how each student did for every single question. You can see what their answer was, and in both cases, you can also see how long it took them to answer the question. Both Quizizz and Kahoot have the ability to download the reports as an Excel file. It's just another added layer of data collection that I personally like. One cool thing about Quizizz, though, is that they have the ability to email parents directly from within the report. It's just an added little button. You click on it, you type in the email address, and it sends a curated report directly to those parents. I don't think it's enough to give it the full edge in this category, but it's a neat little addition. But in this case, we're going to call it another tie. Okay, let's take a look at creating your own Quizizz, and this is where we really start to differentiate between Quizizz and Kahoot. There really are some important differences here. With both platforms, it's super easy to create a quiz. It's intuitive. There's lots of help if you need it. You basically just click, type, go. There really are no issues with creating the quiz itself. You can create multiple choice or true-false questions with both Kahoot and Quizizz. You can toss in images, you can add audio, and with Kahoot, you can even throw in some YouTube videos. However, this is where the similarities end, and this is where Quizizz really starts to take off. When you're creating a question, you can actually go and pull questions from a bank of all the other tests that are ever created by other teachers. You can type in anything you want, it'll pull up a list of all the results, and all you have to do is handpick what you want and insert it directly into your own quiz. Kahoot does not have this option, and let me tell you, it is a game changer. On top of that, the types of questions are more varied. You can do checkboxes, you can do polls, open-ended questions, fill in the blanks, all the things that Kahoot is offering under their premium account, you can do with Quizizz for free. Now, you can tweak the length of time for the questions in both platforms. You can toggle the points, how much each one is worth, so you can get really specific with how much you want to put a value on each question. But it's that combination of different types of questions and the ability to pull from a question bank that has already been curated for you. It really pushes Quizizz way far ahead of Kahoot in this regard. Huge point here. Before we get into our last category, and honestly, it's the most important category, I want to give a special subscriber shout out to Ken Kuong and Miss Galindo. You guys have been sending in some great feedback and some great comments and suggestions for the channel, so props to you. If you're enjoying what you hear today, please consider liking it and maybe subscribing to the channel. In the meantime, let me ask you, are you using Kahoot right now? Or Quizizz? Is there another platform that you prefer? Post in the comments below, claim your favorite, and let us know. Okay, let's take a look at the most important category, gameplay. Both Kahoot and Quizizz offer two modes. You can play it solo as practice or as an assignment, or you can do it together as a class. This comes in super handy if you're going to be doing this virtually. You can be hosting a Zoom meeting or a Google Meet, and you can have this set up to where your entire class can be going through these quizzes and these games together. Super important, they both have it. The way the actual game is played as a class is a little bit different. With Kahoot, it's the teacher running it one question at a time. Once you get everybody logged in and started, the game begins, it goes one question, the timer goes, the students answer, we wait, we see the answer, we move on to the next question. With Quizizz, it's student-paced. Now they can go through it, there will still be timers, however some kids will finish faster than others, and you kind of have to wait until everybody finishes in order to see the final results. They're still both competitions, and they still have the same kind of basis to it, but maybe that helps you decide one way or the other with how you want to run a game. Sometimes with Zoom, it's a little bit easier to do a Kahoot, that way you can just keep track and you can stop between each question before clicking on to the next and have that discussion about why a certain question is the right answer or why some people chose that. To me, that's a little bit better towards Kahoot, but with Quizizz, it helps them feel less pressured for each question. It's not hurry, 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 we have to get this one done, and they can go at their own pace within the time constraints that you've set. Putting all that aside, I want to let you know really quickly that I did Kahoot 5-6 years ago as a fourth grade teacher, and it was new at the time and it blew my mind. But looking at quizzes, I gotta tell you, OMG. The gaming experience with quizzes is unbelievable. Mind blown. Not the least important is the ability for you to have the questions read aloud. That's a button that kids can click and the question will be read to them. That opens up an entire new world for all those kids out there who need that accessibility feature. I love having that available to you. But even if we were to ignore that, they have power-ups, they have themes, they have memes, you can create your own, you can use a power pack. There is so much you can do that excites the kids and gets them amped up and ready to play. As they keep going and they answer certain questions in a row, they get these power-up abilities that let them either get a second guess or keep their win streak going or double their points. As they go through quizzes, they unlock new themes. So if they want to change the music or if they want to change the background of the quiz, they have that ability to earn and grow. And I'm telling you, it grabs your attention. I'm super ADHD. I was looking at it just the other night at 12 in the morning and it woke me up. This is a game changer. So, the winner, I think you know what I'm gonna say. It's Quizizz. And it's really not even close. And I was a longtime Kahoot fan, but the combination of all these different options, the fact that you get it for free forever is really gonna throw it over the top. Hey, are you looking for some more app battles? Go ahead and click right here. You wanna learn some other cool stuff? Check this out right here. See you next time at Mr. Cook's Corner. Bye.